at each other after the job is done. but it is not really good enough alone, you know what I mean? So we've got to have a little humor here, forget it, otherwise it gets too heavy. But once the female's impregnated, she won't let the male get close. The poor guy, I mean, he's got more uses than just one, but she won't let that male get near him again. Once, it's only natural. Once the cow's impregnated, that's the end of it. Right? It's not just for breakfast anymore. It's not just for fun. Sex is... something's gone wrong with our relationship, which addicts us, because we are not meant to be sexual beings. Eventually, this information, if I had time to expound upon it, would help to sort of stabilize the population of the world. Because it's a proclamation that men are not meant to be always sexual beings for a season, yes. That we must transcend and go and come into a beyondness that is more beautiful and more noble than just reproducing animals. See what I mean? And every woman longs for the man, that beyondness in a man, to lead her out of that duty. It isn't that pleasant, is it, ladies? Let's be honest. Come on now. Go on. It isn't that pleasant, is it? I mean, in the formative years, yes. But you get older, it gets old hat, right? And then you see the man is using you, and he's less of a human being, and he's more... And the more you love him, the more of a cad he becomes, right? The more of a dog, the more of a wimp. Because he's never... he's just using you to make himself secure. To get some kind of reassurance for an identity, which is a fallen one. And if you keep supplying that need, you become a party to his sin. And as you, just like the dope pusher is just as guilty for supplying the dope as the dope addict for taking it. Don't you see? Because when you supply the dope, you're doing the wrong thing. When you are tempted to do the wrong thing, it's for power. You're separated from the God of power. And you become a god of power yourself. And now the only way you can hold on to a feeling of security and to be a god of power, since you've lost your power, is to keep supplying somebody with dope, encouraging them to fail, and to get a sense of power over them and from them, a sense of life, to neutralize the truth of your death. A dope pusher, takes two to tango, the dope pusher and the dope addict. I mean, after all, the lion is tempted by the lamb. He's tempted. The weakness tempts, see, for a reaction. So therefore, if it's in a woman, if a woman has no life of her own, no center of her own, she's going to be addicted, attracted, because she needs life. Yes, you know what I'm trying to say? She needs the excitement, the infusion from a failing person, right?
So if you're saying that if a woman is insecure, she becomes lustful, is that?
That's right, an insecure woman is lustful. She dreams of seducing men and men servicing her needs and filling up, see? Just like men dream of women.
And also, if you have a lot of hatred, do you become...
If you have a lot of hatred, it separates you from... Remember what I've said hatred does to a person? It separates you from love. Do you know what makes a woman sexually active for men? I'll tell you what it is. It's hatred towards fathers. When a little child sees the weakness, there it is again, the love or the lust that he has for mother and the control that mother has over the father... The little girl hates the father, because the father is no longer a sensible person, a heaven sent, but he's now the pawn, the extension of the will of the mother, who's a witch, right? Whose witchery he is commanding Service.
Could it also be that you hate your husband?
Yeah, I'm coming to that. I'm just going to go over it just very lightly. So you see, the little girl's resentment towards her father for failing to love her mother and also, therefore, failing to be an example and therefore be a shining source of love so that she could respect and keep her innocence intact. But now, that's what she wants from her father, is love. But the father has no love because he's too busy being addicted and getting love and giving power. So there's no love in the home. The mother's a witch. The father is weak for that love. See that? There's no spirit, no innocence. So therefore, the little girl hates her father. Following me, ladies? Now, what happens when a woman hates a man? I've always said that, I'll say it again, that men fall in love or fall from love, but women fall in hate when they see that fallen man fallen from love. Little girls see that man fallen from love. That's the bad example, that weakness, that sensuous man without love, but he thinks he's got it because he's addicted to his wife. Mm-hmm. See that? Yeah. But he hasn't got it. He's too busy filling up and using his wife. And his wife's too busy filling up on power and becoming a witch. Frustrated one. She sees this. She resents him, hates him. The hate separates her from God's love. She loses her innocence. And now she feels empty.
That's what
now she feels sensual.
Yeah.
And she feels a sensual need for love from her father. She's jealous of the father's love for her mother. Now she goes off looking for love from men,
yeah,
sensually.
That's what my...
Is that right, yeah, ladies? How many see a... Let me see a show of hands who understand that. You do, don't you?
Yeah. Well, my ex-husband went and he had a relationship with another woman and I hated him for that. And now it seems like I'm becoming like he was.
Yes, it becomes very sensually awakening,
yeah,
doesn't it?
Yeah, and I'm doing like what I didn't like him to do.
But know? What will happen is that I know we were speaking on the subject of brainwashing, but now we're talking about identity transference, exchange. What happens is that the hate of the man not only awakens you sensually, but the more you are sensually awakened and perform the loving service that fallen men need to make them fall, so that you fill yourself with his life as he falls.
Mm-hmm.
Now you become addicted to his life and therefore addicted to making him fall. So the life, his essence comes into you, and guess what? You start to become masculine.
Yeah.
And you start to burn like a man.
And it seems like you just need it more and more.
That's right. The sexual burning of a woman that's increasing is only because she is assuming her inner person that really should be more beautiful and pristine and pure, not from this world, not from that relationship, is taking form, taking the form of a masculine inner form. It's filling an inner void with a masculine quality. She feels dirty. She feels icky, right?
Mm-hmm.
Ladies, you understand me? Who agrees with me? Good. Not all of you, but that's that burning that a woman feels is only not because she's a woman,
yeah,
but because she's becoming a man and she starts chasing the men.
Yeah.
And they start not wanting sex. So you have to stimulate them, and then now they'll know what it feels like to be a woman. Why don't you have sex? Well, I got a headache. See?
Yeah.
I guess it's good because then they'll know what it feels like.
Yeah.
Of course, now you also know what it feels like to be a man.
Yeah,
to become addicted, the manly woman addicted to the feminine man. You're chasing him all around the room and he doesn't want to have any. Is that right?
Yeah.
That's how God teaches us, I think, sometimes. Well, it's only because of an evolution downward. You become each other. When you haven't found God, the truth, you tend to make a God of another person to get something from them, but then you only get confused. Your identities become confounded, and you get lost in the shuffle. A little piece of you goes to that person, a little piece of them comes to you, and you don't know who the hell you are anymore. Is that right?
Yeah.
But I was trying to say is that in this war of the worlds, you have just come in out of the cold. you've experienced to some degree the things I'm speaking about, and that you want to transcend your sensuality. That doesn't mean to say you have to become celibate, become a nun or a priest. Not that they're celibate, but... But the point is, there's no need for that. You just have to learn how to relate to each other properly. You know, what more can I say? There's a way, and the way is within, and it's not in any books. I can lead you to the door, give you a little gentle push, and hope it's smooth sailing. And you can listen to my program, and when you're on the journey, you hear other people talking about the journey. And then when you're on the journey, you can check with me. Maybe you run into a little sticky wicket, and I'll know that you're on the journey by the questions you ask me. For instance, if you don't know anything about an automobile, then I could tell by the questions you ask me. But if I know that you're fixing your automobile and you're on the path and you kind of know a little bit already and now you're on the next stage, I know by the questions you ask. I know you're on the right track and I can relate to that. So may I suggest that the audience, if you know, if you're having more sex and liking it less, and if you're having more sex and liking it more, but you haven't got more to give, so you have to drink rhinoceros horns. You're drinking all those aphrodisiacs, and still, you know, until it's, you're just going down the drain with every experience. Then, if you're finding dissatisfaction in that kind of love, if you find it very disappointing, it's only because you're not relating to each, you know, you're not relating to each other properly. Perhaps I can show you how it's done, how to relate to each other. But you, first of all, you have to get into your center, get very quiet, and find that inner life within you so that you won't have to aggravate it out of everybody else. You won't have to draw it from your environment, from one another. Okay? You need to find the humanizing, not the dehumanizing relationship. It's within you. And I suggest that you keep this program on the air, because this is the only sane voice there is on television, right? Even if I say so myself. And radio, even if I say so myself. And but not for everyone, of course. Those of you who love what I'm teaching, help me to keep coming your way Monday through Friday. Be in our audience on Friday night by calling the Foundation of Human Understanding. The telephone number's on the screen. Ask for our meditation package, and the telephone number is on the screen. Give us a call or write to us. Thanks for listening, and join us again.